You know, we talked about Julius. We have Obi here. How do you feel like they manage minutes, rotation? Where do you feel like they go?
That's going to be interesting to see as well, right? Because you would think they play the same position. And so how do they really work together? Mm-hmm. But I find it interesting that one thing that I keep hearing is how athletic Obi is.
Yeah.
How Tim said versatile he is. His ability to shoot from the outside. His ability to play make, run the floor. What does that sound like he's trying to set up?
It sounds like they're setting up Wiley's narrative and putting him at the three. This does, come on, man. Talk to me here, man. You really think they're going to put him at the three?
No.
Well, I mean, what are your options?
Oh, God.
Bench Randle.
I'll ask you this way. Are you sitting your highest paid player?
No. I think Julius is in. Definitely.
100%. Right. Now, you can't play Julius at the five and Obi at the four because you'll have to score 200 points to outscore that duo.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to. The only option, you have two options. Obi comes off the bench. Nobody wants that. Or you play him. This is, you guys old enough remember when Kenny Walker came from where?
Kentucky.
And he came in and he was supposed to be Bernard King's replacement. Mm-hmm. He was going to be your small forward.
Mm-hmm.
What did he play in college? Played the four.
The four.
He couldn't do anything from the outside, but they put him on the wing, they put him at the three, and he struggled. Kenny Walker, slam dunk champ, incredible athlete, right? Guy could run all day long, never got tired, just absolute freak athlete. But when you put him out of the wing, he struggled. Had a hard time, really struggled defending, fouled a lot. So that's what scares me. It's sort of like that. But I do think that Obi at least has something that Kenny never had, which is that outside game, the ability to shoot three.
Right.
He's a lot more of a playmaker, a little more like he's got great court vision. You know, you watch his games, he's very aware. He sees the floor well, he moves well, he anticipates well, all that stuff. And the game's different than it was in the late 80s too, let's be honest. It's a much different game, more space out there. I do think you can...
They're setting it
up. I do think that's an option that they'll try. They'll try to work. But I'm with you. I'm not 100% comfortable with it.
Yeah.
But I keep hearing about how athletic he is and how versatile
they're
he is.
They're setting it up, Jails.
Yeah, that's...
I just can't. Like, I know he has a while to go as a defender. His stance is a little wobbly at this point. And I trust Kenny Payne can fix that. But it just seems like that problem will be exacerbated playing small forward rather than power forward.
Maybe
it seems like it's going to be way worse.
But what are your options at the three? You know, you putting Reggie Bullock there. I mean, is Kevin going to be
think Kev's going to be on an uphill climb regardless. But I think they would put Bullock in there. But I mean, Obi. The thing with Obi, I feel like he has time. You know, let the Randle thing play out. Maybe they have a trade for midseason. And maybe Obi finishes games.
How do you get 20 plus minutes for Obi? And yet Randle still gets his minutes too, and they're effective enough. I just feel like that would create more of a problem. And we also know that Tibbs is a guy that has a five, and he'll play that five till their tongues are hanging out.
Right, right, right.
He wants to play a nine-man rotation, but like, you know, number seven and number eight and number nine are going to get in for like 30 seconds. Mm-hmm. You know, they're not going to play a lot. So that's my other question is, we know how, like, if you know Tom and his history, that's how you sort of try to project things. You watch what he did with certain teams and certain players that he would have in different places. And, you know, I mean, didn't he play him at the three?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, like,
so it's, but also Lou Alden could guard four different positions.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I just think that might be their best option right now until they figure out, you know, the Julius Randle future thing. And maybe it's a way to not have to make Obi feel like you've got to be our star, you've got to carry this team. But to be honest with you, if they're going to do anything and even try to compete for the 7-10 play-in, Obi's going to have to probably be their best player.
I just think he might overtake Randle, to be honest with you. Maybe not from the jump because, you know.
Yeah.
Maybe that happens too. You never know. It could happen. So,
yeah,
but you're asking me again, you're asking me how they're going to handle it. And I'm telling you, that's, you know, I really believe him when he says there's going to be competition for every spot.
Mm.
That includes spots that you think are locked in.
Yeah.
I don't think anything's locked in. He'll probably take the five that play the best together,
mm-hmm.
no matter who it is. So it could be anyone at this point. I just wish I could be in the gym watching, because that's my favorite part is training camp, watching the scrimmages and watching that stuff and just seeing it develop. And we don't get to do that this year.